We've got everybody back?
Yep.
Not quite.
Okay, we're back in session.
I'll call you back. Bye.
Next item on the agenda, item F, resolution for procurement of professional services to 2014-15 capital construction projects. Appendix K, Mr. Hands.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, thank you. This resolution exempts us from the qualification-based selection for architects and engineers or for professional services for our small projects, less than $50,000, where the fee is going to be less than $50,000. And it will allow us to go out and get quotes for those smaller projects and negotiate a fee, and it will allow us also to consider a fee, whereas qualification-based selection, you select the designer without the consideration of fee. So it should be noted that the state, when they adopted this particular piece of legislation, exempted themselves from the requirements of the legislation. So this is our request to exempt ourselves from this for small projects, $50,000 fee or less. And we request the board approve.
Have a question. Will we get a notification about when you make these contracts? I mean.
Yes, this is only for where the fee is less than that. If the project meets the requirements of coming to the board for the total project might be $60,000, but the fee is going to be something less. We will select the designer. We will come to an award. It doesn't change any award requirements by the board at all. It only allows us the flexibility to select a design professional without going through a qualification-based selection and having them submit proposals and all that.
As long as it remains under the $50,000.
Where the fee is going to be less than $50,000, the fee for the designer less than $50,000. It does not affect any other requirements of bringing items to the board at all.
Okay. Move for approval.
Second.
Any other questions? All those in favor, please say aye.
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 Opposed? Approved. Item G, staff development for educators, sole source resolution, Appendix L, Dawn Brinson.
Request the board approve the sole source resolution for the Singapore Math Strategies staff development.
Move for approval.
Second.
Comments, questions?
I'm glad to see we're going to start looking at Singapore Math.
Well, is it just called Singapore Math, or is it actually based on?
Actually based.
Is this the first time we've used it?
We have used it to a limited degree in some of our schools and seen some success. So right now we're running an expanded pilot in 9 of our schools, and we've had some initial training, and this is that secondary follow-up training.
Okay. Any other comments? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? It's approved. Item H, void your Cypress Learning sole source resolution, Appendix M, Dawn Brinson.
Request the board approve the Voyager sole source resolution for the language live training.
Move for approval.
Second.
Comments, questions?
Have we used this before?
We have not used this before. This is part of the training that we're providing to our teachers at Mosley as we're working. Sorry. That was telling me my child should have been in bed already. Sorry. this is software and training that we're using as a part of our revisioning for Mosley. So we're providing the teachers with intensive training so that they have the skills necessary to meet the differentiated needs of those students at that school
site. So this is a professional development program?
This is professional development as well as access to software, yes.
Okay.
Any other questions? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Approved. Item I, Joy Labs sole source resolution, Appendix N, Dawn Brinson.
Request the board approve the Joy Labs sole source resolution for Gregory. This is for their STEM lab that they have been put into place this year.
Move for approval.
Second.
Comments, questions?
Dawn, I'm curious. This is the total is $353.05.
Yes.
Seems like a really small contract for us to be approving. Is it because of Race to the Top?
Exactly. Okay. Anything that's a sole source with Race to the Top has to come to the board.
That's what I thought.
You won't be seeing these after this year.
No.
Any other comments or questions? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Approved. Item J, Compass Learning Incorporated Software Renewal with Sole Source, Appendix O. Dr. Smith.
Yes, I would ask for the board's approval for the Compass Learning Incorporated Software Renewal.
Move for approval. Is anybody going to second it?
Second.
Evidently, there's some questions.
I thought I was out there by myself.
Are there any comments, questions?
I have a concern. Isn't this the third year that we're using this program?
Yes, ma'am.
And we're talking, because my computer won't open up, let me see everything. But we're talking 70-some thousand dollars.
72,000.
72 for the license.
Yes, ma'am.
That doesn't include transportation, doesn't include the cost of the teacher's salary for the after-school tutoring.
No, ma'am.
And initially, I think we were told that we had a hard time getting middle school students to be involved in the program. And I think the report that we received, I think Dr. West presented it, we didn't have a great deal of, I didn't have a lot of confidence in what was reported to say that we should be spending this kind of money for an after-school tutoring program that can't serve all the children and probably is not as effective as it should be.
Well, we do have some additional information, and actually we'll be bringing that formal report to the board next month. We'll place that on the agenda. Part of the waiver for ESEA requires that we offer after school services to our children. And we did survey our principals regarding the overall effectiveness of this of the program, and we had 57% of our principals to rate it as effective or highly effective. And then when it came to moderate or significant impact on student achievement, we had our principals to rate it at 78.5% at the moderate to significant impact on student achievement, so we had them to rate that in the affirmative. And then we also asked our principals about their perception of whether or not we should continue with this program, because we did provide them with the opportunity to choose an alternative, because we do have to provide the service, we do have to make it available. And we had 50% of our principals who wanted to continue with the program as is, and then we had 35% of our principals wanting to continue but with some restructuring. And some of the recommendations and conclusions of the report that was done by the outside evaluator spoke specifically to the need for some restructuring in the program, and so we're going to do that. We're working with the vendor to make sure that that is in place. We also had the recommendation to reduce the amount of time of the program. One comment that was made was that it was just too much for the children, too much for the teachers, because we started very early in the year. This year we're going to start a little bit later in the year. Also, recommendation was that we focus either on language arts or mathematics with students, as opposed to focusing on both. So we're taking the recommendations of the evaluator, and we're incorporating them into the program. But when we went to our principals and we had, I think, 2 to 3 focus meetings, overall, the comments from the principal were that they wanted to see this program back in place, but just structured a little differently.
So this, the computer part is a third of what is being taught during that after-school tutoring? Or?
Yes, ma'am. And with the current structure, that's what was happening. There was face-to-face time with the classroom teacher. There was the opportunity for students to work on homework so they weren't staying after school and then having to be burdened, or having parents be burdened with doing homework with them at home, so they had that opportunity as a part of the after-school program. And then the program is an adaptive program, so children take a pre-assessment, so they enter at their point of need, and then a prescription is written specifically for them, but teachers can add to that. And then those children work through those lessons so that they improve. Some of the challenges where we were trying to do reading and math, and, you know, the recommendation was to focus on one particular area with the child so that that child would receive enough time in that particular area. And so our results were stronger for language arts than they were for mathematics, but we're anticipating with the tweaks that we're making that we're going to see even greater gains with the use of this resource.
Mr. Chairman, if we're going to get a report next month as to the data about how successful this program is and is not, and hearing that only 50% really were excited about it the way it is, I would ask that we table this to the November meeting.
If I could only add one caveat to that, if we do table it, then we would not be able to launch the program in November, which was our initial plan. So we surely can, but then that would just push us back. And it's very difficult to launch a program in December just simply because the multiple things that occur in the month of December. So very likely we would not be able to bring this service to our children until sometime in January.
I can appreciate that, but I also would have said, you know, if you coming to ask for the money, I would have liked for you to have brought us the data for this meeting and so that we could see or satisfy ourselves that, or at least satisfy myself before I voted for it, that this was a program that, number one, was serving, and number two, I'd also like to know what the estimated total cost is. I mean, if we're talking about transportation, if we're talking about teacher salaries to do this, it's not just, as Ms. Nichols said, it's not just the $72,000. I mean, it may be approaching, you know, $100,000, $125,000 when all is said and done.
And we will have to make that allocation in some form or fashion, whether we do it through this program or some other, because we are required to provide the after-school services.
I understand that.
So it has to be after-school. It's not that we couldn't put these resources within the school day for these children.
Now, remember that we had the other, at one time you were using private outside services,
mm-hmm.
and
that didn't
we
work.
Were very dissatisfied with the results. Well, when the federal government provided a waiver on No Child Left Behind, they said, okay, if you don't want to use the private providers, then create your own program. So and we actually did that at a cost less than what we were paying for these private providers. And so the funds have to go to after-school programming. It's not a case where I can say we're not going to do after-school programs and redirect these to day to class time programming.
You know, I guess the question is, you know, if we don't do this, what other options have you looked at?
As I said, we put together focus groups of principals, and so they went back to their schools and they looked at existing resources. They looked at their student need, and then they came together and had conversations and discussions in terms of what programming they wanted to see. So we had discussions from having it be, you know, customizable to each school as to utilizing something that was commercially based. We came to agreement that we wanted to select a program that we could measure the outcomes from so that we could evaluate the effectiveness, and it would be very difficult to do that on an individual basis if you were serving 24 schools and utilizing 24 different programs or 24 different methods of delivering services. And so what we're recommending with the Compass Learning is utilizing that program, but allowing for the customization to be at the school level. So if school A wants to choose ELA for their third graders based on the data that they've got, or if they want to choose ELA for some third graders, math for others, we still could use that data in such a way to evaluate the effectiveness of the program.
Sorry. You know, I guess, you know, I sort of see Mr. Higgins' point that we don't, you know, haven't had the presentation, don't know if it's been effective. At the same time, and I think Mr. Higgins would agree, we need to provide services for these children. And delaying those services really is not a very good option. I would approve this. This is just me personally. But if the data doesn't show that it's been effective over the last couple of years, then we need to start looking for other mm-hmm. alternatives. And, you know, whatever those might be.
Well, we have a motion, a second, and it is money that, I mean, it's less expensive than what we were doing with outside providers, correct? And it's less expensive than what we were paying there, so we'll vote on it. We have a motion and a second if it doesn't pass.
Well, but I would just say that, you know, it is less expensive, but the real problem we had with the other programs that were, you know, commercially available, like Sylvan Learning, was that they weren't effective. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, if they don't work, then it's a waste of money.
But if we don't have regardless data on it, that's the problem I had. Just, you know, with the last presentation we got, there was no substantive data.
Well, and we do, and like I said, we've got the information, but unfortunately it's not finalized. So we were wanting to bring it to you in a final format. But I do have the draft report available with all these stickies.
Who has that responsibility for finalizing the data?
Well, I'm actually meeting with our outside evaluator, I want to say Tuesday, and we're going to go through those pieces to finalize and format the report for presentation so that we can publish.
And maybe I didn't hear you correctly. Can each school, if they need to focus more on the mathematics, if their scores were lower, can they focus on that with this program, or can they choose the language arts component?
Schools have the ability to customize it in that way. So if they want to offer just fourth grade for that entire period of time to a particular group of students, they can.
Okay.
And the previous model, they were getting reading and math. And what we were seeing was that they were not spending enough time mm-hmm. in their area of need. So schools do have that flexibility.
Okay, that's good.
Any other comments or questions? Well, we have a motion and a second. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
With the reservations, aye.
Opposed?
No.
Okay. Motion passes. Item K, Amplify Education Incorporated, FKA Wireless Generation Incorporated, software renewals with sole source appendix P. Dr. Smith.
Yes, I would ask that the board approve the Amplify Education software renewals sole source.
Move for approval.
Second.
Comments, questions? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Approved. Item L, North Carolina Pre-K Contracts, Appendix Q, Dr. Smith.
Yes, we have before you the contracts with the subcontractors. New Hanover County Schools in and of itself is the contract agency for NC Pre-K, and so we administer these funds. And before you are the contracts that we have with the private agencies that serve those students. So we would ask that the board approve those contracts.
Move for approval.
Second.
I have a quick question. I don't have a problem with it. But I was at a forum last night, and one of the discussions was pre-K. You know, I'm very supportive of pre-K. I had a child who went through pre-K, so I know how good it is. But one of the discussions was to what extent we offer the ability for students to go to pre-K. And I think it's important that we address the fact that it's not just the pre-Ks in our public schools, but there are all these others. My question is, can you tell me roughly, I don't have to have an exact number, how many students we are serving through this means of using child development centers and Kids and Company and Child Development Center and Saucier?
I'm trying to remember that number. We have on average 1 to 2 classes at each of these different agencies. I know overall we're looking to serve about 800 students in our NC Pre-K, but that includes our public school children as well. And we just received an expansion. But if you hadn't asked me on the spot.
Wait a minute, you said 800 students, including the public school students?
Yes.
And we serve roughly how many in the public school? About 250, 225?
No, you're thinking just Head Start. We serve 260 Head Start students.
Yes.
Plus we serve kids in the pre-K program. Even though they're both four-year-old programs, one's a federal program, one's a state program.
I understand, but I mean, we've got a couple of classes at Johnson, and we've got Mary Washington Howe. And I'm asking, is the 800 number she gave us, does that include the Johnson and Howe students?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Which, there's what, about 200 in those two?
So we serve about 300 students in our school system pre-K classes.
In our school system?
That's not counting Head Start.
That does not count Head Start.
Head Start's another 260. So we're serving over 500 kids in some kind of pre-K program.
And that I appreciate. Now, what I'm asking is, when you add these, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, these 9
mm-hmm.
facilities, all right, we're over 500 with Head Start and our own pre-K. How many students are we serving in these 9 facilities, roughly?
In these 9 facilities, we're probably serving about 250 students or so, and I can definitely get you the exact numbers. For each class they have, there are 18 students served in that particular class.
So all told, we're serving just under probably 1,000 students through Head Start or NC Pre-K.
Wow. Okay, and so
public and private.
So the instructional services, and I use that term loosely for a pre-K program, are being delivered through these private companies, correct? Or
Well, they have to follow the same curriculum that our pre-K kids.
Yes.
Okay, but the Child Development Center, Kids and Company, these are private companies, essentially.
Yes. They are private companies, and we reimburse them for services as the contract agency.
Okay. Well, it's interesting that Ed brings up the forum and discussing this, because one of the questions, I went to a forum just recently that was with the County Commission and the Board of Education members, and there was a lot of discussion about school choice. I think that was one of the questions that that sort of came up, and a common refrain that I heard was, no public dollars for private enterprise. And here we have an example mm-hmm. of private organizations that we partner with quite regularly that will be benefiting from this and the children as well. So
the irony of that is we actually have to pay the private sites more per student than what we educate students for. This is a mm-hmm. case of where the public does it cheaper than the private entity does.
Yes, our reimbursement rate, I believe, is $437. Their reimbursement rate is anywhere from $600 to $650 per child.
Well, I just thought it was interesting.
And this money comes from where?
From North Carolina.
And North Carolina sends it to us and tells us we have to use it for pre-K.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay, I just want to be, it's, I understand it's state money, but it's not
categorical.
Coming out of our local budget.
Any other comments, questions? All those in favor, please say aye.
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 Opposed?
Opposed.
Approved. Item M, Gifted Advisory Council bylaws and council membership, Appendix R, Dr. Smith.
Yes, I would ask for the board's approval for the Gifted Advisory Council bylaws and council membership.
Move for approval.
Second.
Comments, questions?
Well, I think Ms. Colville's on this committee, so I'm going to hold her personally responsible for any problems with the gifted programs.
All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Approved. Item N, Little Bits Electronics Sole Source Resolution, Appendix S, Dawn Brinson.
Request that the board approve the Little Bits Electronics Sole Source Resolution again for Gregory STEM Lab.
Move for approval.
Second.
Comments, questions? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Approved. Item 13 was our call to the audience, non-agenda items. We had no one to sign up, so we'll move to item 14, correspondence. Any correspondence any board members would like to share? Hearing none. Item 15, under announcements. Item A, the New Hanover County Board of Education will hold a special meeting on Tuesday, October 21st, 2014 at 5 p.m. in the New Hanover County Board of Education Center in this room. The only item on the agenda will be a closed session pursuant to North Carolina General Statute 143-318-11A1 and 115C-402. Item B, the next regular meeting of the New Hanover County Board of Education will be on Wednesday, November the 12th, 2014 at 5:30 in this room. Item C.
Wait, I have an additional announcement.
Pardon?
I have an additional announcement.
Okay.
ACES, the Advisory Council for Exceptional Students, is holding a parent forum, their first parent forum, on November 17th from 6 to 8 p.m. At UNCW Watson School of Education, room 162. And I don't know, Tabitha, can you add that to the announcements for next? Thank you.
Maybe just send that as an email.
Mr. Chair, if I can piggyback on that, you know, transition fair is coming up. Board members might want to come to that too. And I don't remember the date on that. I don't have that, but you just jogged my memory.
I think we have received an email.
You did get an email. I just wanted to make sure that you knew about that.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's in the member.
Also, the policy committee of the New Hanover County Board of Education will meet on Wednesday, November the 12th at 4 p.m. in this room.
I think Ms. Smith left. Ira left, but was Ms. National School Lunch Week or something?
Yes.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Sorry she left before I could comment on that. But please make her aware that I didn't miss the importance of the National School Lunch Week. And I was thinking about her.
Any other announcements that...
What are we going to do without you?
If not, we'll need a, and Mr. Bullard, if you would, we need a motion to go in closed session, pursue it, and
personnel.
Is it my understanding that it's for personnel?
Personnel updates.
It'll be 143-318.11A6.
We have a motion. Second. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Thank you. We're in closed session.
All right.